50s had sat on all of us like a boil. Those of us who were sort of on the new sort of crazy surrealistic left that really came to fruition in 67 with the March on the Pentagon, you know, people like Abby Hoffman and Jerry Rubin, we were sort of precursors of them, if you will, at that point. And what we wanted was to disturb society. We couldn't stand the complacency of society. We hated, I think among other things, we hated the Cold War. We hated the air of oppression that sat over everything because of the Cold War and the way the powers that be were manipulating everything and using the Cold War in order to be able to run their little game the way they like to run it. So we saw ourselves as icebreakers, as people who were going to smash all this stupidity and this congealed lard that sat over the public mind. It never occurred to us that there's a certain part of the public mind that loves being installed in congealed lard because it makes life a lot easier if you don't have to think a lot of the time.
Was always, you know, taking on causes, jousting at giants and windmills, you know,
the
CIA,
yeah.
The police department, you know,
police departments everywhere. Yeah,
police departments everywhere, the gendarmes, as he would call them. It's all very, very much Don Quixote to me. It's funny because he actually shot a film which was his modern version of Don Quixote. And I wonder if he thought of himself that way.
Well, the whole idea was The Adventures of Don Pedro. It was a hip Don Quixote. Doc insisted that a feature film could be made in 2 weeks for under $1,000. And he set out to prove that. And the 6 months and $5,000 later,